BT's Body and Balance is sponsored by Canada Diagnostic Centers, offering MRI, X-ray, and ultrasound services in Calgary and Okotoks.
Heart disease is a leading cause of death for women, yet many still do not recognize this. For Heart Month, our health specialist, Leah Sarich, outlines how men and women can differ when it comes to heart attacks as well as treatments.
Yeah, and this is something I talk about every year in February because it still surprises me that this message is not really getting across, that women and men develop heart disease exactly the same. They're both at the same risk. And yet women sometimes fail to recognize this, and they have all the same risk factors. So let's go over those as we do every year. Age, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, smoking, sedentary lifestyle, obesity, diabetes. The same for both men and women.
Right.
However, the one big difference is that women develop heart disease later in life because of the protective effect of estrogen. So usually women are developing heart disease after they go through menopause when they lose that estrogen. So they develop it a little later than men. So that's one of the big differences there. The other main difference is that women may develop slightly different symptoms of a heart attack than men, or they may not. So it could be the same as men, or it may not. They may be different classically when we think of when it comes to heart attack. But it's critical that women know that what these symptoms are so they can be aware of that. And they also need to be aware of those risk factors so that they know if they're having these symptoms, they're not brushing it aside as heartburn, that like, oh, wow, I could be having a heart attack. So in order to do that, you really need to know what those symptoms are.
Women may, when they develop a heart attack, may not have the classical central chest pain. They may have some unusual arm pain, neck discomfort, or nausea. So not the classical symptoms. So they may put off follow-up of the symptoms, present later, and as a consequence, the impact of that event may be more severe.
Right, and the impact being a greater damage to that heart muscle. So they really have to recognize that those symptoms that they're having may be, in fact, be a heart attack. The other thing they really have to do is call 911 right away. Because I've said it before on the show that if you're going to have a heart attack, Calgary is the place to do it. We have the best outcomes following a heart attack in the country, if not the world, in Calgary. So this is the place to do it. And the reason is because of that speedy treatment right away. So they'll get you in right away for the treatment that you need. But you just have to recognize, of course, that this is happening. So this leaves women at greater risk if they do not recognize this for other symptoms after that heart attack, things like heart failure or heart rhythm disorders. They can be more at risk of those things if they're not getting that treatment that they need right away. That said, there are new cutting-edge treatments for things like heart failure happening all of the time. Some, in fact, right here in Calgary. In fact, one new thing that they're working on, research shows that it's this new pacing therapy. So this is where they put a pace, sort of like a defibrillator in women. And they found that for women, this new pacing therapy, where doctors pace multiple sites in the heart, it actually works better for women than men.
A number of studies now have shown that women benefit more from that therapy if they have heart failure than men. And part of the thinking in relation to that is that the cause of their heart failure is often different than the cause of heart failure in men. So men who develop heart failure are more likely to have had a previous heart attack and scar, and whereas women who develop heart failure are more likely to have enlargement of the heart and weakness of the heart muscle, but not scarring.
So the women don't have the scarring that the men have. So basically, they've got more muscle to work with when it comes with this new pacing therapy. So that's just an example of how they can be more successful with some of these new treatments.
Now, are more women with heart disease getting into those clinical trials?
Well, what's happening is basically is there's more awareness now that women and men can both have heart attacks and that there is some differences when it comes to women and men. But as I mentioned earlier, women tend to have heart attacks and develop heart disease later in life. So what happens is you've got women in their 80s saying, would you like to participate in a clinical trial? They may be less inclined to do so than men who are being asked, say, at 60 or 70. That said, there is more of a concerted effort, certainly, to get more women into these therapies, knowing that they could kind of have a different outcome, certainly, in the end.
Absolutely. Yeah. Interesting. An important message, and one that we hear
every
this
year.
Time, every year.
Yes.
Thanks very much, Leah.